Dr. Oro, thanks so much for joining me. You gave an incredible talk and discussed this idea of therapeutic reprogramming.
Yes.
Can you tell me what that means?
Sure, it's a long word. That means that has a hard to say. But the idea is that with the confluence of stem cell biology and the ability to edit the genome to fix errors in the DNA, we have the ability now to make personalized stem cells for you, for each individual, and then take those stem cells and then manufacture broken or diseased organs in the body. And so the idea is that in the past we'd have surgery where if it's bad you cut it out, and medicine where you can give them a pill. But if you have a diseased organ that you can't cut out because you need it, like the heart or the skin or the brain or the pancreas, for instance, now we have the capability of actually making personalized stem cells and then generating those organs for you to put it back in for transplantation.
So you could grow someone a heart made just for them from their own cells?
Right. So the big picture really is that these embryonic stem cell-like cells called induced pluripotent cells have all the instructions you need to make organs in your body, because they did it before when you were when you were born. And so now we're just going back in time, taking these cells that now have the instructions to make the organs for you, and then developing recipes, if you will, to then manufacture the organs. Now obviously that's the concept. The idea is, and so we've done this for skin, where we can take diseased iPS cells and then correct genetic defects for particular diseases, such as epidermolysis bullosa, which is a disease where your skin comes off because you're missing one of 12 proteins, correct the little defect, and then manufacture the skin back so you can graft it on the patient and correct it.
So you're fixing their cell outside their body and then giving
it back
to them.
That's
really fascinating.
That's right. And so the idea is that you need a number of different things. That the talk was about. You need to be able to manufacture on a clinical grade these iPS cells for each individual person, and then correct the genetic defect, manufacture the cells, but then the key is to then have scaffolds and bioengineer them in the right way so that they'll actually incorporate into the body and into a normal way.
You can't just stick it in.
Well, I mean, you can use a shoehorn or, you know, but really those four things are really what we need, and that's where we're moving in the future here at Stanford.
That's so exciting. Has it happened with any organs beside the skin? Have you been able to do a heart or a lung or anything of that nature?
Yeah, so if you look back, we've been for many years now doing bone marrow transplants, where you can take bone marrow cells and bone marrow transplant. And in fact, many older men have been doing it with hair transplants. And so those are like the earliest stem cell transplants. Truth in advertising, I have not had that yet. But now we're trying to develop new organs that where you can't do it easily. And the first actually is going to be probably done by the group in Japan for macular degeneration.
For eyes.
For eyes. And then after that, with their lead, as well as for, here at Stanford, we'll hopefully move into skin and other organs as well, using our new cell facility that we're building here at Stanford.
Do all tissues have the ability to have stem cells? Can we find these, as you said, these pluripotent stem cells anywhere?
Yeah. So the big aha in stem cell biology in the last sort of decade is that every organ in the body has a group of cells that they set aside for a rainy day in case they need to regenerate. And the question really is, not really do they have stem cells, but how do you coax them out? And also, how do you get enough of them to regenerate the organ? Because the blood, for instance, does it all the time. Your skin regenerates all the time as well. But other organs, such as heart or your brain, there's small subsets that have these stem cells. But you have to be able to try to expand them. That's the really difficult. So another way to do it is to make these embryonic stem cells, and then you can grow them at large quantities, and then generate this huge manufacturing to make the tissues. The trick is, though, to incorporate them into the tissue in a functional way, and that's going to be easier for some tissues than others. So, for example, the neural connections, you know, you can probably stick some cells in there, but the connections that define your personality, your memories, and your experience, that's going to be really hard to replicate.
So we're not going to go stick a new brain in someone. That probably wouldn't work.
No, I don't think so. I mean, Frankenstein notwithstanding, I think we're not going to be able to do that. But aspects of that will be helpful.
This is really exciting work you're doing. Thank you so much for speaking with me.
Yep, thanks for having me.
Pleasure.
Yep.